got interested recently in attaching a numeric keypad to a micro bit to try and revive one of my calculator projects. It'd be really useful if you could just have a numeric keypad so you could enter numbers in. And got thinking about how to do that. Did a little bit of research. There's lots of clever things you can do using keypads that you can buy, using different resistors and things to read different values, using very few pins on the micro bit. But I also got interested in thinking a little bit at a fundamental level about how calculator keypads work, or how normal numeric keypads work. And the way that I think most of them work is they have some sort of matrix. Keys are arranged in rows and columns, and the device, the processor, whatever's running it, reads, it scans rows and it scans columns to try and work out what key you're pressing. And you can buy keypads that you can connect to Arduinos and even micro bits very inexpensively, but I didn't have one. But I do happen to have a lot of these push buttons, so I thought I'd have a go at making my own keypad matrix. So the first thing I did was, using a breadboard, I've wired up 12 buttons, and with these jumper wires, and there are some little silver jumper wires that you probably can't see hidden under here. What I've done basically is to wire up 3 columns and 4 rows, and I've pulled all of these columns and rows out on the breadboard, and they're all connected to different pins on the micro bit. And if you have a look at this diagram over here, if you can see that, you can see exactly how I've wired it up and which pins I've used on the micro bit. Now, the upshot of that is, as a proof of concept, I've written a very, very simple MakeCode program. What the program does is it sends a digital write signal out onto each of the rows in turn, and then scans every column and reads each column to see if it's getting a signal. Let's just see if this works. As I say, it's a proof of concept. There are lots of problems with this. It's very slow for one thing. Doesn't do with multiple key presses, and it's not happy if you hold the key down. But anyway, let's try this. So imagine this is a calculator keypad with the same sort of layout you'd have on a normal calculator. So we've got across the bottom row, across the top row it goes 7, 8, 9, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, and then I've got a clear key, 0 and a decimal point. So let's start with the top row. So we should, if I press that, see a 7. There we go, 7 lights up. If I press the next button along, I get an 8. Next button along, 9. And then let's do the next row. We should, on this row, get 4, 5, 6. 4, 5. And 6. You do have to hold the button down quite a long time, and I'll show you why that is in a minute. Next row, 1, 2, 3, and then the bottom row should be clear, 0 and decimal points. So if I hold that one down, we get clear, we get 0 and decimal points. And there we go, that works. Kind of works. Let's look at how the program works in MakeCode. We've got a forever loop which keeps scanning the rows and columns. The first thing we do is to write pin 8 to 0. I'll explain why we do that when we get to the end of the loop. And we then set pin 0 to 1. Now, pin 0 is the first row, the bottom row. So we're going to scan kind of from the bottom up. So we scan the bottom row by sending a digital signal out on that row. And then we read each column. Now, the columns are on pins 16, 13 and 14. And if we're in the bottom row, if we've got something on pin 16, if you look at the kind of matrix, that must be the clear button. If it's pin 13, it must be 0. And if it's not any of those, I want to clear the display. So I've got an else block and I'm just going to show nothing on the display. Now, we've set pin 0 for the bottom row to high, to 1. So we need to turn that off when we scan the next row up. And then we go to pin 1 for the next row, and we scan the columns to look for buttons 1, 2 and 3 and show those. And then we do the same for the next row, 4, 5 and 6. 7, 8 and 9 are the top row. And of course, because when we scan the top row, we've set pin 8 to high. We've sent a signal out on pin 8. When we get back to the beginning of our loop, we need to set that low, which is why I've got digital write pin 8 to 0 at the beginning of my loop. Otherwise, we'll have a problem. And it's quite neat because you can see, actually, you can see the pins scanning along. This is how a calculator keyboard or a computer keyboard works. It's scanning the matrix of keys, and you can see this happening. Part of the reason why my keypad doesn't work very well is it's very slow, and that's because having a forever loop in MakeCode does introduce a small delay, and you can get around that. We can put a while true loop in here to speed things up, but I just thought I'd leave it for now.
in its slow forever loop, so you can actually see the scanning going on the pins on the simulator, and it's quite nice. And it does actually work. You can actually see when you press a button on the keypad that I made, you can see the different numbers light up. Making something happen with that and actually reading that data and doing something with it and debouncing and all that kind of stuff is much more complicated, but it was a really fun project. It was a nice proof of concept that I was able to completely from scratch wire up my keypad matrix, my own keypad matrix, and then write a make code program for a micro bit that would actually read it and show the different numbers on the display.